I want to tell you a story about evolution, devolution, and just maybe revolution. To tell the story, we have to go back to the beginning. Bum, 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 bum. I told you we had to go back to the beginning. So 230 million years ago, dinosaurs make their appearance on the planet. For the next 100 million years, they are the dominant animal roaming the Earth. But then, they died. And what emerged to replace or surpass these reptiles were hairy, warm-blooded creatures that gave birth to live young and nurse the mother's milk. Some of them grew bigger, hairier, a bit odd. What were they called? No, they weren't called furries. mammals, because of these. But it's not all about the mammary glands. It's about what came out of them. Civilization. Other mammals, sure, they nursed their young with mother's milk. But we humans, we took the mammalian design and rode it for all it was worth. Our bigger brains, adaptability, we changed the way we harnessed energy, built shelter, changed communication, the way we handled our food resources, and even self-governance. But you know what fueled the change, gave us the startup capital? Breast milk. And for 100,000, or actually for 250,000 years ago, since humans came onto the planet, we had great breastfeeding rates, like 100%, except for a Neanderthal or two. And, you know, we were really built on this stuff, literally grown on this stuff. This is what really made us who we were, nourished our life force, made us what we are, what we do. What could possibly stop that? Like you didn't see that coming. So somebody somewhere gets the idea to take breast milk from one species and feed it to another. How'd they do that? Well, they got it into receptacles and eventually bottles, and they got those bottles into babies' mouths, and they got them to drink it. And most of them lived and grew on the cow's breast milk. By the 1800s, pasteurization, industrialization, and formulaization changed life for us the way we knew it. And what once took a village now took a factory. By the 1900s, the deal was sealed. The stuff that mommy cows feed baby cows becomes known to us as milk. And the stuff that we were sustained on for a 250,000 years, that becomes known as breast milk. Like it's important to differentiate it from, say, elbow milk or knee milk. So the scales are tipped at this point, and it takes a real key figure to cement this radical shift into place. Okay, let's get this straight first off. I'm not here to bash formula or to demonize cows, right? Formula can be medically necessary, and in rare cases, it's life-saving, but it's absolutely abundantly available as a substitute for human milk when human milk isn't available. But it comes with risks. So when I was back in medical school, I learned a lot about a very precious human fluid, blood. Hours and hours learning about the intricacies and the balance and the different components that were in it. Classes devoted strictly to the risks of substituting for blood with transfusions. But in medical school, I got 2 hours of breastfeeding education. And today's doctors, combined medical school and residency, 8-9 years, they're lucky if they get 2 hours of breastfeeding education. Would that surprise you then if I told you a recent survey of physicians showed that 40% felt that breast milk and formula were equivalent? But they're not. Millions of years of mammalian evolution designs this complex, dynamic, species-specific design ensured to help infants survive and thrive. And I don't know if you know this, but did you know that a mother that delivers a preterm baby makes an entirely different type of breast milk than a mother that delivers a full-term baby. Each making breast milk specifically designed to the gestational age that their baby is at the time of delivery. How about the fact that if a mother gets an infection, she makes antibodies to that infection and then delivers those antibodies through her breast milk to her baby to fight that infection? Now, formula only has the most basic building blocks of breast milk: fats, sugars, proteins, but it doesn't have these. And these are just some of the components of breast milk, more being discovered each year. Some of these you can't make outside of the human body. So what happens when a mother makes breast milk and a baby receives it? These are dose-dependent effects of breastfeeding. Dose-dependent meaning the more you do, the better the effect. The more months you breastfeed, the higher these benefits. And the converse is true. If you formula feed, the risks of all these diseases go up. More cancer, more obesity, more death. The kind of things that we spend billions of dollars trying to fight on the back end, when if we could get breastfeeding rates up, we could be fighting them on the front end before they happen. Now, I know what you may be thinking, because in the 21st century, when you talk passionately about breastfeeding and about all the benefits of breast milk, you risk being called that, or maybe that one. But 100 years ago, 300 years ago, 1,500 years ago, do you know what you called that person who was urging you on and trying to help you breastfeed? That. Because they knew that if you didn't breastfeed, your infant was going to die. They weren't pushing you because of the long-term health benefits. They didn't have the resources or knowledge or skill set like the modern-day physician. Yes. Modern-day physician with scientific method and evidence-based medicine at our disposal. Heck, we've even mapped out the human genome, and we get 2 hours of breastfeeding education? Really? I guess it shouldn't surprise us, right? It was only a few decades ago that physicians were still denying the ill effects of smoking in spite of the data that was facing them. So it shouldn't surprise you that without a powerful figure to oppose the feeding changes that were going on in our society, that breastfeeding rates dropped through the floor. In 1971, in the United States, only 1 in 5 women even attempted to breastfeed. And that's not even the real guts of the matter here. In less than 100 years, the art, the knowledge, and the teaching of breastfeeding from grandmother to mother to daughter was gone. Economics dismantled us as a species. $4 billion is the value of the U.S. formula market. And I'm all about entrepreneurship and capitalism, but there's a reason that study after study shows that the promotion of formula, the freebies, the giveaways, the bags going out of the hospitals, the free formula out of the hospitals and offices, they diminish breastfeeding. Formula, the industry, is a for-profit industry, and that's all good, but don't forget that every baby that doesn't breastfeed is a formula customer. Let's take a quick look at a global example. Two countries, huge economies, how do they deal with this formula issue? One of them chose to completely ban and prohibit formula marketing. The other threw the doors open wide. Can you figure out which one's which? China's formula market in 6 years goes from a $1 billion to a $3.5 billion industry. So in the end, it comes down, I guess, to dollars, because formula makes a lot of money. And the thinking is that breasts don't, unless they look like this. But the truth is, breasts do make money thanks to what comes out of them: savings. The federal government put out something called the business case for breastfeeding, which shows companies for every dollar they spend on a comprehensive breastfeeding support program in their workplace, they realize a $3 savings. That's a $3 return on investment, which is huge. And Harvard did 2 huge studies looking at the health benefits of breastfeeding and said if 90% of women in the United States would exclusively breastfeed for the first 6 months, as is recommended by the American Academy of Pediatrics and the CDC, that we as a nation would recognize $30 billion annually. Now, I took an oath. And back then, we didn't know the risks of not breastfeeding. Though we do now, or doctors should now. As a healthcare industry, as a society, we did this to ourselves. So what do we need to do to fix it? Well, we need to train and educate physicians and healthcare workers on how to support breastfeeding. We need to inform, and we need to educate moms and families about the benefits of breastfeeding. We need to demand that healthcare services, support, and equipment and donor milk are covered health benefits. Let's get crazy. How about 3 to 6 months of paid maternity leave? Let's go back to the beginning. Let mammals be mammals and see what comes out of them next. Thank you.